Now turn to part 3, questions 14 to 19. For each question, write the correct answer in the gap. Write one or two words, or a number, or a date, or a time. You have 20 seconds to look at part 3. You will hear a boy giving a class presentation about his older sister Megan, who has a butterfly named after her.
Hi, I'd like to tell you about my older sister, Megan, and her trip to Brazil. Megan's 19 now. As a kid, she was really keen on butterflies. She had a pencil case with a picture of a butterfly on it. She just loved it. After that, people started buying her stuff with butterflies on, like t-shirts. She even had a bed cover with butterflies on. They became, like, her special thing. So, when my uncle saw a competition to name a new butterfly that had been discovered in South America, he got Megan to enter for it, with our parents' permission. I never thought she'd win, but she did. She suggested calling the butterfly Megan, like her name, and wrote to them explaining why. Megan's always liked wildlife. Everyone thought she'd study biology at university, but she's actually doing geography. As part of her course, she has to spend a month doing research in another country. So, Megan decided to go to South America so she could look for her butterfly. And it's incredibly rare. Only about a dozen of them have ever been seen. Lots of butterflies are brightly coloured, like there's yellow ones and orange ones, but Megan's one's just brown. Maybe that's why nobody ever sees one. In Brazil, Megan spent 10 days trekking through the rainforest and saw lots of brilliant things, like a village that you can only reach by river. Then, on the last day, she was sitting next to a waterfall when a butterfly settled on her rucksack. Megan wasn't quick enough to take a photo, but the scientists with her confirmed that it was the real thing. If you'd like to see a drawing one of them did, it's on the university website. Megan said it was, like, an awesome experience.
Now listen again.
Hi, I'd like to tell you about my older sister, Megan, and her trip to Brazil. Megan's 19 now. As a kid, she was really keen on butterflies. She had a pencil case with a picture of a butterfly on it. She just loved it. After that, people started buying her stuff with butterflies on, like t-shirts. She even had a bed cover with butterflies on. They became, like, her special thing. So, when my uncle saw a competition to name a new butterfly that had been discovered in South America, he got Megan to enter for it, with our parents' permission. I never thought she'd win, but she did. She suggested calling the butterfly Megan, like her name, and wrote to them explaining why. Megan's always liked wildlife. Everyone thought she'd study biology at university, but she's actually doing geography. As part of her course, she has to spend a month doing research in another country. So, Megan decided to go to South America so she could look for her butterfly. And it's incredibly rare. Only about a dozen of them have ever been seen. Lots of butterflies are brightly coloured, like there's yellow ones and orange ones, but Megan's one's just brown. Maybe that's why nobody ever sees one. In Brazil, Megan spent 10 days trekking through the rainforest and saw lots of brilliant things, like a village that you can only reach by river. Then, on the last day, she was sitting next to a waterfall when a butterfly settled on her rucksack. Megan wasn't quick enough to take a photo, but the scientists with her confirmed that it was the real thing. If you'd like to see a drawing one of them did, it's on the university website. Megan said it was, like, an awesome experience.
Now That is the end of part 3.